Welcome back, dear student. Today we start with the lecture 4, topic entitled Nuclear Transport. So what is nuclear transport and its major role in molecular biology, its importance in molecular biology? Let's start with introduction. So all eukaryotic cells contain the various organelles like ribosome, cytoplasm, mitochondria, endoplasmic reticulum, Golgi bodies, and vacuoles that execute different activities like ATP synthesis, protein synthesis, or protein transportation to sustain a range of cellular functions. The largest among them is the cell nucleus, which is surrounded by nuclear envelope, which contains three parts: outer membrane, lumen, and inner membrane, and stores genetic information in the form of chromatin, heterochromatin, and euchromatin. Nuclear transport refers to the mechanism by which molecule moves across the nuclear membrane of a cell with the help of this nuclear pore. So all molecules from cytosol to nucleus mainly transported from this nuclear pore. Large molecules are actively transported between the nucleus and cytoplasm. How? The small size proteins mainly transported from this nuclear pore complex very easily or passively without any energy requirement, while the macromolecules or large size protein mainly required proteins for their transportation or a special system for their transportation from cytosol to nucleus, or out proteins move from nucleus to cytoplasm. The entry and the exit of large molecules from the nucleus is tightly controlled by the nuclear pore complex. Small molecules can enter the nucleus without any regulation, without any protein, or without any energy, while the macromolecules such as RNAs, RNA protein like RNA polymerase, DNA polymerase mainly required associated with this transport factor, which is known as nuclear transport receptor or NTR. Like karyopharynx. Karyopharynx is a protein family which is contained mainly used in this important to enter the process which required important protein enter the nucleus. Proteins enter to the nucleus from cytoplasm to nucleus. Exproteins mean exit. The proteins exit out from nucleus to cytoplasm. Larger molecules are actively transported through nuclear pore complex and must contain specific information in order to transport it. How this process occurs? Targeting of nuclear protein up with different steps. Like in step 1, you can easily see nuclear protein mainly contain NLS. What is NLS? Nuclear localization signal, a specific signal required for transportation. So this is nuclear protein which contain NLS signal and which bound to a complex of important protein. Important protein mainly two parts, alpha important and beta important. Alpha and beta important bind with this nuclear protein and make this complex. In this nuclear protein, alpha important and beta important complex bind with this nuclear pore complex and pass through this, where the resulting complex bind to nuclear pore and translocated is mediated by which enzyme? RAN-GTPase. RAN-GTPase inside the nucleus. This process occurs inside the nucleus while the previous steps occur in cytoplasm. So inside the nucleus, important beta dissociate, you can see there, important beta mainly dissociate from important alpha, and important alpha which is still attached with this nuclear protein mainly release the nuclear protein. After beta separation, alpha release this nuclear protein and transported it cytoplasm to this nucleus where it's required. And then important alpha and important beta are transported out from nucleus to cytoplasm for further cycle. Then this cycle continues for targeting nuclear protein for their further steps. Next target protein. So what is nuclear import? Important protein Mainly this NTR or nuclear target receptor NTR protein bind with the cargo protein in the cytoplasm. What is cargo protein? Cargo proteins are mainly carrying transport motif that enable their interaction with different complex coat complex move dynamically between compartments within the secretory and endocytic pathway. So after this, it is which they able to interact with this nuclear pore complex and pass through it channel inside the nucleus, where inside the nucleus then RAN GTP cause conformational change and the important cause the dissociate it from, as you can see, dissociation of cargo protein with important protein with the help of this RAN GTP age. So after this dissociation, this RAN GTP then move out from nucleus to cytoplasm, where RAN GTP interact with, this is RAN GTP interact with guanine nucleotide exchange factor or GEF, which replace the GTP with GTP and resulting again the RAN GTP and beginning the cycle. So this is nuclear import cycle. After this, nuclear export cycle. So what happened during nuclear export cycle? This cycle is roughly reversible to import process. In the nucleus, the import cycle, what happened? The process start from the cytoplasm ended within the nucleus, and in this process start within the nucleus. So what happened in the nucleus? The exporting protein, this is exporting protein, nuclear transport receptor. The exporting protein binds to cargo, this is cargo protein as you can see, and diffuse through the pore, and this RAN GTP, cargo and NTP makes complex and diffuse out from nucleus to cytoplasm. Then RAN GTP bind to gap protein, RAN GTP bind to gap protein and resulting gap and hydrolyzed GTP and resulting RAN GTP complex is restored to nucleus. Again it restored to nucleus where it exchanged its bound ligand for GTP. Hence where important proteins mainly depend on RAN GTP to dissociate from its cargo, exportins mainly required RAN GTP in order to bind to their cargo proteins. The RAN GTPase control the direction of nuclear transport. What is RAN GTP? RAN is a small GTPase that is common to all eukaryotes and is found in both nucleus as well as in cytoplasm. The RAN gap, as you can see, which is present in cytosol, contains GTPase activity protein which promotes hydrolysis of GTP by RAN, while the RAN GEF, which is present in nucleus, or also known as, what is GEF? Guanine exchange factor, promote exchange of GTP for GTP RAN. Multiple classes of RNA are exported from nucleus, like messenger RNA, tRNA and ribosomal subunit 60S or 40S produced in the nucleus and exported through nuclear pore complexes to function during translation in the cytoplasm. The same NPCs used for protein transport are also used for RNA export. Exports of RNA is receptor mediated. Different types of receptor which are energy dependent are available. Like different soluble transport factors are required for transport of each class or different classes of RNA, as in you can see in this diagram. The major routes of RNA export, the transcripts undergo processing and associate with the export receptors. Different types of receptor like NX-F1, CRM1, which is it, and RAN GTP attached with this CRM export, Expo5, and this figure show the representative export receptor for each RNA. Like this is nucleus and these export from nucleus to cytoplasm for translation. Start with major export receptors. The major receptor for messenger RNA in all mammals cells are mainly NX1 and CRM1, but for messenger RNA 5, which is 5 prime capped, are mainly use F1 receptor. NX1 receptor for CRM1 dependent mRNA export, mainly NX1 function in bulk mRNA. These NX1 mainly useful for bulk RNA, very huge mRNA. You can easily see this polyadenylated and capped mRNA or hnRNA molecule mainly use NX1 export receptor. But CRM complex is mainly useful for small RNAs, where ribosomal RNAs, USN RNAs, and certain substance of mRNAs are exported in CRM dependent manner. You can see 5 prime capped, but there is no poly A tails. So these SN RNAs can export from nucleus to cytoplasm with the help of this receptor CRM1, which contain trans-GTP activity. And then ribosomal export in mammals the pre-60S subunit, as we know, ribosomal RNA mainly contains 60S subunit and 40S subunit. So pre-60S subunit is exported by this CRM1, which contain trans-GTP, CRM1 receptor exporting or expo5, this is not mentioned, or exporting 5, or also known as expo5 in tRNA. You can see in miRNA process. So expo5, where is the pre-40S subunit is exported by only this CRM and 60S subunit mainly NMD3 function to in the export of 60S subunit. This NMD3 is mainly for 60S pre-60S with this CRM. When it's combined, it's only mainly responsible for 40S subunit, while this combined with NMD3 receptor, it's mainly transport this 60S subunit. After ribosomal RNA export receptor of tRNA, the main transport factor for tRNA is exporting 1 or this export, also known as export invertebrates. Export is a member of the important beta family, and like CRM1 is regulated by small GTPase RAN. As you can see, this RAN attached with the CRM export, this RAN also attached with this export. Okay. After tRNA, microRNA. What is microRNA? MicroRNA are small RNA molecules of approximately 22 nucleotides that regulate gene expression via RNA splicing. miRNA is processed in both nucleus as well as in cytoplasm. Therefore, the miRNA traversing the NPC is a precursor pre-miRNA rather than a fully processed miRNA. Most of miRNA is transcribed as a primary miRNA by RNAP in the nucleus or RNA polymerase in the nucleus, and pre-miRNA has, as you can see, this 5 prime cap and local hairpin structure. Exporting 5 or expo5 function in the export of pre-miRNA with trans-GTP similar to CRM1 and this export protein. This is also called to control contain small trans-GTP activity.